I think we can kind of get at some of these issues with a randomized hill climbing quiz. So what was kind of what is the advantage of doing hill climbing and what does it lead to in terms of being able to find the maximum? So he yeah, Charles, this is going to be a quiz, and I guess you're not particularly happy about it. But let's take a look here. We've got an input space of 1 to 28, the integers. And so here it is kind of out on the screen, all the values from 1 to 28. And here's the fitness function or the objective function for each of those points. It sort of follows this, not exactly sawtooth, kind of piecewise jaggy, I don't know what to call it.
Drunk.
It is what it is. And here's the global optimum. And what we're going to do is we're going to run randomized hill climbing, and we're going to run it this way. We're going to assume that the algorithm chooses randomly in both if both directions improve, so it just flips a coin 50-50, then it does whatever evaluations it needs to do to figure out which way to move to go uphill. We'll use as the neighborhood of X to be the thing immediately to its left and immediately to its right, unless, of course, you're at 1 or 28, in which case there's just one neighbor. So we're just going to use a simplification of the hill climbing that we had before, which is it's going to check the neighbors, check both the neighbors if there's two of them. And if one of them is an improvement, it's going to go in that direction. If neither of them improvement, then it's going to declare itself at a local optimum. And if both are an improvement, it's just going to flip a coin to decide where to go. And once it gets to the local optimum, let's say it sort of climbs up this hill and ends up at this peak here, it's going to realize that it's at a local optimum. And then it's going to trigger a random restart and pick a new X position to start at. And now the question is, how many function evaluations on average is it going to take to find X star, the tippy top of this peak? So, you know, maybe you could write code to do this, or maybe you could do it with math. This is probably a little bit more involved than most of our quizzes, but it should give you a chance to really dive in and get a feel for this notion that it matters kind of where these basins of attraction are. All right, do you think that's clear enough to give it a shot?
Sure.
All right, let's go.